the most news in the morning. CNN's American Morning, weekday 6 a.m. Eastern.
It was photographing his brother, but seeing his father that gave him the inspiration.
It's one of my favorite shots of him. I mean, he looks, to me, nose and mouth, and with the glasses, looks more like Lennon than Lennon. I mean, that's why it's Lennon by Lennon.
After spending his music career in the shadow of his famous father, Julian Lennon wanted something all his own. So in the city his father loved, he premiered his first photography exhibit.
How did you get the bug to get behind the lens?
I think it was only probably 3-4 years ago when Sean was on tour in Eastern Europe, and I decided to surprise him on the road and brought a camera along. And it was only after I got home and started editing through those pictures that I sort of went, oh, I kind of like this. And one thing led to another.
It had just been a hobby until that point?
Until that point, yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
It led Lennon to capture intimate moments through a series of landscapes and portraits with subjects like Kate Hudson and the band U2.
This is one I wanted to ask you about because it's a picture of Bono beneath a picture of your father.
Sure. Well, you know, I mean, we did discuss this. I think it's very much, you know, a very special picture for me because he looked up to Dad and I look up to him and Dad. So it's that was goosebumps for me when I took that shot.
Goosebumps that surely returned for Lennon the night of his opening. After decades of disagreements and infighting, the entire Lennon family, including his mother Cynthia and Yoko Ono, came together for the first time.
How did that make you feel when everybody was together in the same place after so many years?
I mean, the one thing I didn't want it to do was overshadow the show, being a little, you know, selfish in that regard. But the fact that we all ended up in the same room together, hugging and kissing, was pretty phenomenal.
I can imagine.
I don't think many people thought that would happen.
The reunion, bittersweet, a stark reminder of John's absence. And more reminders are coming.
Very significant date coming up in just a few
Apparently
days.
Apparently so.
Yeah. What would have been your dad's 70th birthday?
Yeah.
Where do your thoughts run when you think about that significant anniversary?
First and foremost, I think, what age am I and what age he would have been, and how weird is that just to begin with? But, you know, these days I look back with a fondness and with respect and with, you know, in awe, in many respects, of the achievements that he gained throughout his life.
You know, this is a question I've asked people over the years. Mark David Chapman came up for parole.
Sure.
Again, just a couple of weeks ago.
Sure.
Was denied for the sixth time.
Yep.
Should he ever be released?
I can't answer that. You know, there's supposed to be room in our hearts, in all of our hearts, for forgiveness. My own thoughts are personal on that and are my own and will remain that way. That's for me and my own thoughts in my own quiet time.
Do you think his life would be in danger if he were ever going to
Absolutely. Yeah. No question about it. You know, I don't wish harm on anybody, but I think that if he did get out, someone would try and hurt him. That's for sure.